These days, the buzzword on the social media is that bad boy cholesterol. Well, everyone talks about cholesterol, everyone thinks cholesterol is bad. Cholesterol causes heart attack, cholesterol causes brain strokes. Everyone is just scared about this word. In this video, I'll give you precious 8 simple life hacks to keep that bad boy cholesterol at bay. Sit back and take a listen. Hello friends, welcome to Doc Loss Channel. I'm Dr. Arun Naik, a doctor for 30 years and a neurosurgeon for 20 years now. Dialogue with your doctor is called a Doc Log. In this channel, we have Doc Logs related to brain and heart health, lifestyle diseases, cancer, spine health, preventive health, and much more. We also give here simple effective tips to put you on the positive side of your health. If you're new here, please consider subscribing to Doc Logs. What is cholesterol? Cholesterol is a waxy, oily, fatty substance which runs in our blood. The cholesterol is very, very important in the cell structure of every cell in the body. It helps in maintaining the cell membrane or the cell border. It also helps in the production of some of the important hormones like cortisol, which is very, very vital to the functioning of our bodies. Friends, we all know that diet very high in cholesterol is dangerous to our health. This statement, however, is half true. Yes, your dietary cholesterol makes only about 25% of cholesterol source your body gets. The remaining 75% of the cholesterol comes from your liver. Yes, liver produces 75% using byproducts of fat metabolism. Let's come to our blood cholesterol. In our blood, the cholesterol is packed in tiny protein fat packets called lipoproteins and is circulated in the blood. There are two types of lipoproteins. One is called LDL or low density lipoprotein, which actually causes what's called as an atherosclerosis. In atherosclerosis, the LDL along with the other fats gets deposited inside your arteries, blocking them. And these deposits are called plaques in medical terms. These plaques will eventually block the artery. These plaques can cause heart attack if a heart artery is blocked, and brain stroke if a brain artery is involved. So in essence, this LDL is a villain and is a bad cholesterol. LDL, L is for loafer. Then there is another higher density lipoprotein or HDL. So this HDL, big bro, is a hero. So this big bro carries his younger bro LDL out of the arteries and takes him to liver, and liver eventually removes him from the circulation. So HDL is good cholesterol. So again, to reiterate, LDL is younger bro and is a bad boy. HDL is a big bro and is a good guy. Cholesterol story is not that simple, friends. There is one more bro called VLDL or very low density lipoprotein, which is again a bad boy and a bad cholesterol. Wait, there is a cousin of these HDL, LDL and VLDL called triglyceride. This triglyceride guy is also bad, but in a different sense. To know about these interesting brothers and cousins, please watch my channel for videos on cholesterol, where I have dissected all this cholesterol to give you a better understanding of our heart and brain health. Friends, now you know the cholesterol strategy, isn't it? We need to increase our HDL or good cholesterol, and we have to reduce our LDL or bad cholesterol. It makes sense now. I'm sharing here my 8 tips and tricks to balance your cholesterol levels and make sure you don't land up in heart attacks and brain strokes during your lifetime. Bear with me, friends. It's a longer video and makes every sense to watch till the end to get most of the benefits of optimal cholesterol levels. Number 1, monounsaturated fats. What are monounsaturated fats? Friends, I will simplify chemistry for you. There are 2 types of dietary fats, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated fats are solids in room temperature. Examples are animal fats, ghee, coconut oil, etc. These saturated fats are not good for your health. Well, there is an exception, coconut oil. Watch my separate video on coconut oil and its role in keeping us healthy. Now, let's pass on to the second variety of fats. They are unsaturated fats. There are two types, monounsaturated and polyunsaturated, depending upon how many double bonds they have. Mono has one, poly has a few double bonds. Monounsaturated fats, they increase the good cholesterol HDL in our body and lowers the bad cholesterol LDL. The finding that monounsaturated fats could be healthy is the result of seven country study during 1960s. It showed that people in Greece and other parts of the Mediterranean region enjoyed a strikingly low rate of heart disease and strokes despite being on a high fat diet. The fact was the main fat in their diet, though, was not the saturated animal fat common in other countries. The magical fat was olive oil, which is a monounsaturated fat. This study produced a plethora of interest in olive oil and the Mediterranean style diet. A type of eating started as a cult today. Watch a video in my channel on Mediterranean diet and how you can get the most of it without overtly changing your palate. The other source of monounsaturated fats you can include in your diet are canola oil, nuts such as almonds, walnuts, flax seeds, pecans, hazelnuts, and cashews. One fruit deserves an honorable mention here, avocados or butterfruits. Avocado is the fruit of the avocado tree, scientifically known as Persea americana. These days, avocado has become an incredibly popular fruit among foodies. It's often referred to as a superfood. It's very high in monounsaturated fats and antioxidants. This super fruit is very heart and brain friendly. Let's go to number two, polyunsaturated fats. Because of the presence of multiple double bonds, they behave differently in the body compared to their saturated counterparts. Polyunsaturated fats reduce bad LDL cholesterol and decrease the risk of heart disease. They also increase good cholesterol HDL so that your heart and brain are healthy and the arteries are clog-free. Polyunsaturated fats also seem to reduce the risk of metabolic syndrome and type 2 diabetes. What is metabolic syndrome? Please check my video in my channel. I have the link in the description box below. Well, metabolic syndrome is strikingly dangerous, especially in younger than 40 years of age due to increased heart attacks and brain strokes. Well, when we talk about polyunsaturated fatty acids, you remember an omega watch. Omega-3 fatty acids especially are heart healthy type of polyunsaturated fats. They are found in seafood and fish oil supplements. Omega-3 fats are found in high amounts in fatty fish like salmon, mackerel, herring, and deep sea tuna, and to a lesser degree in shellfish including shrimp. That's if you're a non-vegan. What if you're a pure vegan? Yes, you can have walnuts, sunflower seeds, or flax oil. That takes us to our tip number three, trans fats. Friends, listen carefully for this part of the video. If one thing you need to consider in the whole episode, please consider this one. This trans fat is a big killer. Most unhealthy, most disease-causing type of fat. These fats do exactly opposite of the other two types of fats, meaning they increase the bad cholesterol LDL and decrease the good cholesterol HDL, thereby clogging your brain and heart arteries. Trans fats are unsaturated fats that they have been modified by a process called hydrogenation. Why modification? Well, this is done to make the unsaturated fats in vegetable oils more stable as an ingredient. Well, this is done to make sure the unsaturated fats in vegetable oils more stable as an ingredient. More stable, I mean, you can keep on frying potato chips without having to worry too much to change the oil. All that you need to do is just top up a little bit of oil, and that makes a terrific business sense for the restaurants, but terrible sense for our society's good health. The resulting trans fats are not fully saturated but are solids at room temperature. This is why food companies use trans fats in products like spreads, pastries and cookies, because they provide more texture and body to your snacks than unsaturated liquid oils. If the industry has even little bit of concern about mine and your health, friends, they should immediately stop producing this monster killer. Many countries have successfully banned this fat, but still these fats end up in your favorite food joints, making billions of dollars of business by just changing the labeling of the oil. Weird, isn't it? It's weird but true. In 2006, New York City banned trans fat from its restaurants and eateries. A study has shown that the heart attack and brain stroke rates have become significantly less after the ban. The US is trans fat free since 2018. I wish other countries around the world should ban this mass killer before it kills millions more people. Canada, UK, Belgium, Austria, Denmark have put a cap on the amount of trans fats in their food supply chains. Read the ingredients in food packets, friends. If a product contains partially hydrogenated oil, it has trans fats and should be avoided at any cost. Now let's go to the next tip, tip number 4. Very, very important tip. Exercise. Friends, exercise is a simple, effective and free way for good health. Not only it improves your physical fitness and helps reduce your waistline, it also reduces that harmful LDL and increases beneficial HDL. I tell my patients that 30 minutes of activity 5 days a week is enough to improve cholesterol levels and reduce the risk of heart attacks and brain strokes. Any physical activity that elevates the heart rate to around 80% of its maximum is optimal, as it increases HDL and decreases LDL. So walking, cycling, gymming, cardio, swimming, a game of badminton, the choice is yours depending on your physical abilities and pre-existing health issues. Please check with your physician if you have any health issues before embarking on a new exercise journey. Well, from exercise, naturally I go to tip number 5, weight reduction. If you're overweight even by 10% by guidelines, you are very likely your cholesterol levels are helter-skelter. Once you are overweight, your liver gets confused and tries to produce more cholesterol to balance your weight. In the bargain, your liver produces more and more bad cholesterol and less good cholesterol for some reason. The consequence of increasing your waistline and bad cholesterol is definitely a recipe for a heart and brain disaster. Once you are overweight, you also stop exercising and become lazy. Amount of fat in your body and laziness, friends, are directly proportional. Don't get into the vicious cycle of weight gain. Fortunately, you can take heart from the studies. Studies have shown that you may be able to reduce your cholesterol levels significantly by losing 5 to 10% of your body weight. Reaching this goal isn't necessarily easy, but you can always begin with small steps. First, make up your mind. Add physical activity into your daily routine in simple ways, such as walking up and down the stairs instead of taking that elevator. Replace a fast food lunch in your office with a homemade healthy meal. Believe me, friends, I am talking from my experience as a doctor for 30 years now. It's effective. Get into the groove today. Let's go to the next tip, tip number 6. Kick that butt. One more lifestyle change needed here is about smoking. When you think of smoking, you often think of lung cancer. However, smoking can adversely affect your heart and brain health in several ways. One of these is by changing how the body handles cholesterol. Cigarettes contain a ton of toxins, including a particularly reactive chemical compound called acrolein. Friends, acrolein is a yellow, foul-smelling vapor that is produced by burning plants like tobacco. It's also man-made and is so lethal, no wonder it is used in both pesticides and chemical war weapons. Acrolein is easily absorbed into the bloodstream through the lungs, and scientists believe it contributes to heart disease by affecting the way your body metabolizes cholesterol. It causes reduction in good cholesterol, HDL, and increases bad cholesterol, LDL. Hence, in smokers, heart diseases and brain strokes is 2 times high compared to non-smokers. The best way to reduce your risk for heart disease is to quit smoking today. The good news is that quitting smoking completely can significantly improve your levels of HDL cholesterol, which helps protect your heart and brain. From stopping smoking, it takes me to tip number 7, alcohol. Drink in moderation. Various alcoholic beverages like beer, liquor, and wine all have different effects on your cholesterol levels. Moderate drinking considered to have a protective effect on your cholesterol and heart. Here, I'm not advocating alcohol as a tool to reduce your cholesterol, friends. Please understand, if you are a teetotaler, you can skip this tip. If you are a drinker, please listen carefully for what I am saying here. These facts are not mine, they are published and circulated facts. The links are in the description box below. Moderate drinking is defined in medical literature as 1 drink per day for women and 2 drinks per day for men. 1 drink equals about 360 ml of regular beer, that is 5% alcohol, 270 ml of strong beer, that is 7% alcohol, 150 ml of red wine, that's around 12%, 45 ml of distilled spirits such as gin, rum, whiskey, scotch, tequila, or vodka. Studies have shown that moderate drinkers were significantly less likely to have a heart attack when compared with people who didn't drink at all. Many studies have shown drinking moderately also reduces your risk of developing brain strokes. Moderate alcohol consumption can raise your good cholesterol HDL levels by increasing the speeds of transportation of lipoproteins in the blood. There is a warning again here. Drinking more than what it is considered moderate, however, has an opposite effect because it can raise both cholesterol and triglyceride levels. It can cause havoc by leading to premature heart attacks and strokes. Binge drinking is even more worse, friends. Binge drinking is drinking heavy alcohol in a short period of time. It can cause brain stroke, and I see this happen very often, especially on weekends for obvious reasons. So friends, again, a warning from neurosurgeon. Drink responsibly for society, family, and your own health. Let's go to the last tip, but not the least, tip number 8, dietary fibers. Eat dietary fiber. I am sure your doctor has told this before, isn't it? Dietary fiber, found mainly in fruits, vegetables, whole grains, and legumes, is probably best known for its ability to relieve your constipation. But friends, fiber foods found in beans, oats, flaxseed, and oat bran may help lower your cholesterol levels by lowering low-density lipoprotein or bad cholesterol levels. Fibers also are shown to reduce blood pressure and inflammation inside your arteries, thereby reducing again the incidence of brain strokes and heart attacks. With that, friends, it's time to stop this video. As I told at the beginning, this marathon video was worth watching, isn't it? Now, I'm sure you know what is cholesterol, what is good cholesterol, what is bad cholesterol. You also know now what measures you can take to bring down your cholesterol levels to be heart and brain healthy. I hope you like this video. Please give me a big thumbs up and share this video with your near and dear ones to put them also on the positive side of their health. If you are new here, please consider subscribing to Doc Logs. It'll be my great honor and privilege to have you guys among this ever-growing community of Docloggers. Hit that bell icon to get instant notifications of my new videos. Friends, if you had a high cholesterol, tell us in the description box below what measures you took to balance your health. And also tell us anything I missed mentioning in this long video. If you have a tip of your own, please go ahead and mention. We'll all learn from it. Friends, I'll be back with another equally interesting Doclog very soon. Till then, feel awesome, live awesome, and yes, take good care of your health.